If a college student at the University of Alabama Googles the word Farrah Hall looking for the building on campus, they're in for quite the surprise. This Farrah Hall, a windsurfer from Maryland competing in the Olympic Games, breezed past the popularity of a lecture hall in Tuscaloosa.
The last time I checked, it was in front of me, so I'm pretty happy to have overtaken the building Farrah Hall.
After beating the Crimson Tide online, Farrah looks to take on the rest of the world in windsurfing. 10 races, 5 days, all four shot at 3 medals. Farrah's mother, Linda, hopes a golden wish comes true in England.
I would be totally astounded, and I hope that comes true.
The only windsurfer in the family, Farrah taught herself the sport.
She took to the windsurfing immediately, and she didn't know a thing about it, and she took it out on the Magathie River, and when the wind blew her out into the bay, she didn't know how to turn around and come back against the wind because she didn't know anything about tacking. So what she would do is she would ride always with the wind, and when she got way out, she would flag boaters, and boaters would come over to her and haul her back in.
We were all kind of beginners sailing back and forth on the river, and we were visited by an Olympian windsurfer, Mike Gebhardt, who's a multiple medalist. And I was already really athletic, and you know, meeting him, you know, put windsurfing on my radar as an Olympic sport, so I decided to go for it, and that was 10 years ago.
Cue the meteoric rise. Farrah started to race in international competitions and netted a slew of sponsors who beam about her incredible story.
Her voyage started many years ago. She and I connected about 4 years ago, and really was a long shot, and we looked and saw she had all the wirings, if you will, of a real winner, a real competitor. And so we bet on her, backed her, and became her number one supporter, and I've become her number one fan.
While we're stuck in a sweltering summer, Farrah and the rest of the Olympic athletes must adjust to the chilly climate and challenging course in London. That's not a problem for Farrah. She's already studied the place like it's the final exam of her sporting life.
London is a very cold venue. It's going to be very cold and rainy and probably quite windy. But I've done a lot of training there. I was there for 2 months before coming home, competing and training, so I have quite a bit of experience at that venue, so there won't be any surprises.
As for bringing back that medal to Maryland, Farrah sounds mighty confident to finish first.
I'm there to have the performance of my life, and I've really done all the preparation that I need to do to have the performance of my life. In reality, like I have it all right now, and so I'm pretty confident going in.